Places you go to, if you don't comport yourself well, and the power of God passes you by, you may never contact again. See, I can't help anybody. It's only God that can help. If you are able to communicate to God effectively, listen to me, you are living here with a testimony.
Yeah.
Hear me, guys. I've been on a fasting for weeks. Praying daily. Hours in prayer. I don't need to shout today. The angels of God are here already.
Amen.
The spirit that walks with my spirit father is here already.
Amen.
So I don't need to come and be doing shouting and be doing drama. Say shout ye, shout you. No. You need your faith to come alive.
That's right.
Am I a magician? You must talk to God on your own. Hannah was barren as long as her mouth was closed. But the year she went to Shiloh. This is your Shiloh today.
Yes,
the test you got there, he said, oh, that thou wouldest answer your handmaiden and give me a song. That day, a story changed. Listen to me, it is immaturity when you are waiting for prayer points. Don't you know what is wrong with you? Oh, do I need to tell you? I go to in the spirit. I went to Ogbomosho. Where you from? Say Ogbomosho, everybody begin to cry. Is that what you came to do? Don't you know you're from Ogbomosho? My house shall be called the house of prayer, not the house of storytelling. This morning, if you are sitting down on your own, you are going to pray to God. I'm going to read you the next 2 minutes. All of you outside in the gallery, and those of you inside here, those of you watching us online, you are going to go before God. Lord, this is the month of August. Change my story. Answer my prayer. Visit me, O God. There are some things in your life that I cannot know, but the Holy Spirit knows them. You are going to pour your heart like Hannah did. Jesus, as we begin to pray the Holy Ghost, you will go before God in prayer. Those things in your foundation that has been contending with your glory, you will bring them down today. Say, my Father, my Father.
My Father, my Father.
You shout it louder.
My Father, my Father.
Say, my Father, my Father.
My Father, my Father.
As I begin to pray.
As I begin to pray.
Every ancestral confrontation.
Every ancestral confrontation.
Confronting my glory.
Confronting my glory.
As I turn my hands in prayer.
As I turn my hands in prayer.
God, die in the name of Jesus.
God, die in the name of Jesus.
Now open your mouth and push in prayer. Yes. Push in prayer. 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 Push in prayer.
Yeah.
20 more seconds. Push in prayer. Push. Some ancestral altars, their assignment is to turn your glory to shame. And let me tell something, guys. Time does not change it. Time only reveals it. If you are failing today and you are saying time will change it, you are deceiving yourself. Time will only reveal to the world that you are a failure. You are going to pray this prayer. As the choir sing that song, you will listen to me. If you are shaking your head and your Brazilian hair falls away, let it fall. It's better your Brazilian hair fail than your destiny to fall.
Amen.
Yes,
sir.
Amen. Amen. I cry to God, Jesus, every power turning my glory to shame. On this altar, let those powers expire. Let those forces catch fire. My glory must be restored.
Amen.
My glory must be restored.
Amen.
My destiny must manifest.
Amen.
Shout, my Father, my Father.
My Father, my Father.
Are you shouting louder?
My Father, my Father.
Every power.
Every power.
Turning my glory to shame.
Turning my glory to shame.
As I turn my hands in prayer.
As I turn my hands in prayer.
It's power.
Open your mouth and pray.
Bye.
Amen.
Lift up your hands toward heaven. Every garment of shame. Please just focus on Jesus this morning. Every garment of shame, shout fire.
Fire.
Garment of rise and fall.
Fire.
Garment of disappointment.
Fire.
Garment of disfavor.
Fire.
Garment of shame.
Fire.
As your hands are lifted, I stand in my office as appointed and a privileged office, appointed by the Lord under the grace of my Father. Every strong man standing at the gate of your destiny, please lift your hands up, please. As your hands are lifted, every power that stands at the gate of your destiny to divert your good, to abort your breakthrough, to cause disappointment, as you shout amen, that strong man is uprooted now. Money today, no money tomorrow.
Fire.
You have today, don't have tomorrow.
Fire.
As your hands are lifted, I stand in my office and I speak to those demonic powers. From this moment, they aspire in the name of Jesus. Every altar collaborating with ancestral powers. Frustrates your destiny.
Fire.
As those hands are lifted and you shout amen, I command that conspiracy to scatter. To scatter. Please lift your hands, please. Every structure in the realms of the spirit that has been put in place to perpetually siphon your glory.
Fire.
As your hands are lifted, watching me online, inside this hall, outside this hall. In the name of Jesus, let those structures collapse in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Every monitoring spirit, monitoring you for future calculated attacks.
Fire.
That spirit has been monitoring you since you were born.
Fire.
Every tree my Father has not planted shall be uprooted.
Amen.
I prophesy.
Amen.
Every monitoring power that monitors your destiny, as you shout amen, I disconnect you now.
Amen.
Every voice of the accuser,
fire,
that stands to accuse you before your helpers,
fire.
There's somebody here. The fire of deliverance is about to fall on you this morning. They promise you something in the morning, and by afternoon time, they change their mind. It's not because the people are wicked, it's because there is a monitoring spirit that goes to misrepresent you before those assigned to help you. As your hands are lifted this morning, every monitoring spirit that goes to misrepresent you before those that God have appointed to help you, as you shout amen, let those spirits die.
Amen.
Whatever the covenant in your ancestral household, every covenant in your father's house, covenant in your mother's house,
amen,
covenant in the family you married into, responsible for rise and fall,
fire,
by the covenant of the blood, let that demonic covenant scatter in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
After this service, the custodians of your household that determines who rise and who falls, ancestral strong men that are the determining factor in the realms of the spirit, to determine who prospers and who remains poor. I stand in my office under this ancient power of Yahweh, under this ancient power of Jehovah. Let those demolish strong man, ancestral stronghold, ancestral custodian. Let them release you in the name of Jesus. Can the bread be taken from the warrior? Or the lawful captive from the fierce? He said, even the lawful captive shall be delivered.
Amen.
I said, I will contend with them that contend with him.
Amen.
I will feed them with their flesh.
Amen.
They shall be drunken in their blood.
Amen.
I prophesy.
Amen.
Every battle that you have entered into, every balabatalapa, every battle you have inherited, inherited from your parents, from your husband, from your wife, from your friends, I decree in the name of Jesus, let those battles expire. My Father, you know the intents of men. You know the motives of men. Father, you know, I don't stand here to deceive your people. I stand here to bless them. Father, you have appointed me in this office. And so I stand here with all fullness and confidence. And I prophesy a blessing over everyone hearing me in the name of Jesus Christ. From today, your areas of struggle, your areas of shame, areas where you toil, you see what you want, you cannot have it. Because some power say you will never have it. I stand in my office by election. Let those powers release you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
From this service onward, a process of progress has been set in motion.
Amen.
A process of recovery has been set in motion.
Amen.
A process of rising has been set in motion.
Amen.
From today, pattern of demonic activity ends in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
It ends in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
It ends in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
It ends in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
No, don't put it there, please. Just hold it. Hold it in your hand. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
You know, now there's all kinds of things in the body of Christ. People watch live broadcasts just to criticize. And that is why you see a time is coming in this generation that there will be a generation that will be so judged by God. Because the Bible says, it said, don't be ye mockers, therefore strengthening your bounds. When you are mocking the move of the Spirit, you are strengthening your affliction. It means you are strengthening them, you are making it stronger. If your affliction was 1 gig before, when you start mocking, it becomes 20 gig. When you continue in it, it becomes 1 terabyte. And the time comes, the consumption will be so strong that people will be wondering, what did you do? Who did you offend? I pray that the spirit of mockery is an end time spirit, will not find its place in your life.
Amen.
In the precious name of Jesus.
Amen.
I want you to, for 1 second today, just thank God for what he's about to do in your life today.
Wow,
in fact, what he has done already, by those prophetic ballistic missiles.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Father.
We are grateful, Father. We appreciate you.
Give him glory.
We appreciate you. We give you the glory. We give you the honor. We exalt your name, O God. We thank you.
Thank you.
We appreciate you, Father. Oh, we are grateful for all you have done. Thank you, Lord. Receive the glory. Receive the glory.
Thank you, my
Lord. We thank you. We give you praise.
Shining in the light of your glory. Pour out your power and love as we sing glory.
Shining in the light of your glory, oh, pour out your power and love, as we sing, holy, 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 holy,
right.
That window shines is as if it are still under shackles. Let the devil know that you are no more under his shackles. Let him know that you are no longer under his bounds. Let him know you are no longer bound. Come on, jam those hands together.
Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have worshiped. Please, you may be seated in his presence. Give yourself a big, big, big hand this morning. Praise the Lord. The few minutes we have to share God's word, I pray that your eyes will be open to receive. That the eyes of your understanding will be enlightened. That you may know what is the hope of your calling. What is the riches of your inheritance in the saints. And what is the exceeding greatness of the power towards what we believe, according to the workings of his mighty power, which he wrought when he brought Christ to life and set him at his own right hand in heavenly places, far above principalities and powers, above every name that is named, not only in this world but in that which is to come. You must understand, brothers and sisters, your eyes must be open for you to grasp and understand and benefit from the things that God has sent his son to die for. Today, many Christians, please, remain on the key, please. Just play straight on the key for me. Many Christians today are laboring and there's no result because their eyes are not open. The greatest prayer you can pray for yourself is that your eyes be open. Ignorance is one of the reasons why many Christians are where they are. To make progress in the kingdom, you have to be intentional. Progress in the kingdom is never a fluke. You know a fluke? When you used to play snooker, you know, pool ball. When we were playing it, you mistakenly put it, but say it's a fluke. In the world of the spirit, there is no fluke. Everything is intentional. Please hear me very carefully this morning. We have just a few minutes. I promise you won't keep me here waiting. And every of you coming here today, those of which watching us online, this thing you are listening to today is worth hearing. I didn't hear a big amen to that.
Yeah.
So, as a child of God, you've got to be intentional in your dealings with God. If you want to make progress in this kingdom, two things you need to understand. You must have the knowledge of who God is. Number two, you must have a knowledge of his ways. You must have a knowledge of who God is, and you must have a knowledge of his ways. There are two different things. The Bible says that God made his ways known to Moses, but his acts, he made it known to the children of Israel. If you know the ways of God, it becomes easy to command the acts of God. The acts of God can mean prosperity, deliverance, breakthrough, sustainable progress, enviable destiny. But you must first of all understand who God is and understand his ways. Who says a big amen to that?
Yeah.
So you must know his ways and you must know who he is. The month of August is a month of prayer, answered prayers. On Friday, I'm going to be showing you some deep revelations, continue from where I stopped today. Prayer is not an option for a believer. Prayer is not an option for a believer. Prayer is a sign of humility before the Lord. Every time you go to God in prayer, you are saying to yourself, Lord, I cannot do this thing, only you can do it. You are saying, Lord, I can't fix my destiny, only you can fix it. Prayerlessness is a sign of pride before the Lord. And God resists the proud and gives grace to the humble. While most Christians are wallowing where they are, it's not because God is wicked. It's because they are not praying enough. I was sharing with the workers this morning. I said, the Bible says, you ask not and you receive not. You receive not because you ask not. And said, you ask not and you ask amiss, that you may consume it upon your lust. But let me show you something. The Bible didn't say you pray wasted. It said you pray amiss. You may want to hit a target. You don't hit the target, but you are still hitting something. You are not hitting the target, but you are hitting something. And that in the realm of the spirit, there is no void. There's no vacuum. Well, that's what I'm saying. I'm saying this because prayer is never wasted. When I people say, I've been praying for 2 years, those prayers you are praying, watch it. If it doesn't show in your life, it should show in the life of your children. If it doesn't show in the life of your children, it will show in the life of your community. There are some people that God will put a burden on their heart to pray. That prayer is not for bread and butter. That prayer is for a communal deliverance. Because prayer is God's authorized system of communication. Every time you pray consistently, you open a portal in the realm of the spirit. There's a communication where angels ascend and descend. If your home becomes a prayer place, very soon, have you not wondered sometimes you enter a house, say, this house, there's a devil be here. There's a place you enter, your body, somebody tells you, this place is not normal. And there's some place you enter. When you enter there, you say, I feel God in this place. Why? Because a koinonia has been going on in that premises. Somebody has been summoning on heaven to bring down the blessings upon that house. So prayer is God's communication system. Some Christians have flattered themselves. I don't need to pray. I have intelligence. I don't need to pray. I have beauty. I don't need to pray. Hear me, guys. Man is a spirit. When you became born again, your spirit became born again.
That's right.
And your life operates in the spirit. Anything you will ever owe or have in this life, first, it must be in the spirit. So prayer is the vehicle that you take things in the realm of the spirit and deliver them here on earth.
Oh, yes.
For as soon as Zion travailed, she brought forth. Where did she bring it from? There's a realm. The Bible says, "We have been blessed. Blessed be God that has fully blessed us with all spiritual blessings in come on now, in heavenly places." Heavenly places. There is a realm called the heavenlies where your destiny has been preordained by God. That place where you stay in the place of prayer, Kepora, Erando, Zibata, Jesus, as you are praying, you are opening the portal for the blessings to begin to pour in. That is why when you see a man who prays, be careful of that person.
Yeah.
Bible says, Jacob had power with God after an all-night prayer. Have power with God. Everything you will ever need, Ephesians 1:3. Everything you will ever need in this life, they are all in the spirit. That's sometimes when you are praying, or your mind tells you something, says, I know that I ought to be a millionaire, but something, you can't explain why that millionaire person has not manifested. It is because that millionaire person is in the spirit already. So the heavens are summoning you, telling you, daughter, son, there's something in the spirit, but you need to push more. You look at your children, something tells you, this boy will be great, but you cannot explain why that boy is misbehaving. Why? It's because that boy's destiny, your spirit is already capturing his reality in the spirit. So as a mother, as a father, what do? You go to the place of prayer. Where the child was originally hailed from. Where the child originally came from. And you begin to contend that the originality of the child will manifest in the physical. Prayer is not an option for a believer. When you are prayerless, listen to me, guys. The devil can take your house, take your money, take everything. But the moment your prayer is taken, there can never be a recovery. But let him take everything from you. The moment you go on your knees, those things can be replaced. As for a believer, there's what they call abundant life. Abundant life. That abundant life is available to the man that is a believer. Why? Because you see a man that is broke, disgusted. He has lost everything. He goes back to God in prayer. You see that same blessing comes back again in his life. Bible says that Job lost everything. But when he went to prayer, pray for his friends, Bible says that he had twice as he had before. Listen, guys. The devil is only deceiving you, telling you that your prayer is a waste because you're not seeing it physically. Many years ago, Brother Hagin, senior of blessed memory, his wife, Loretta, had goetia. And in those years, there's no breakthrough medicine. Goetia, you know goetia?
Yeah.
Her leg was swollen. Now, in her family, there's history of premature death. You can check this in his book, Prayer on Prayer. There's history of premature death. So Hagin said, no, this cannot happen. He went to God in prayer and began to pray. The third day, God said to him, he said, your wife was supposed to be taken by this thing. He said, but because you have stood in prayer, I have reversed the case. See, brothers and sisters, don't ever let anything tamper with your prayer life. You must maintain it consistently. A man that maintains a consistent prayer life, he becomes an altar. I wish God would open your eyes this morning to what I'm saying. These are deep mysteries that is not for children. A man can become an altar. When as people say they are going to the field to go and burn an altar, you don't know who you are yet. A child of God that spends time in prayer can become an altar. That even though he's in the water, he can issue a decree to the village. Listen, guys. It is ignorance when you see that begin to complain. Hear me, guys. It may look as if it's not working now. Just keep at it. Keep doing it. For when the cloud be full of rain, it will empty itself. The time of emptying, nobody knows. But one thing that is sure is that it will empty. Every time you feel a restlessness in your spirit to pray, don't ignore it. Lift your hand. Say, Father, in the name of Jesus, I command a revival on my prayer altar. Come on, say, I command a revival on my prayer altar. Come on, somebody, kebolobo shataba. Come on, somebody, outside, inside. Anywhere you are, in your home, online, open your mouth. I begin to pray in the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Give the Lord a big, 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 big hand. The womb that gives birth to what is in the spirit is called prayer. The womb that gives birth to what is in the spirit is called prayer. Is first in the spirit. That's when you pray to a point. There are times when I'm praying, I know that there's victory. I release that 5 million. I break the barriers. As you are praying, your eyes gazes on the things you want to see, the physical. Then days later, somebody calls you and say, I just feel led to sow this 5 million to your life. Guys, listen to me very carefully. In the spirit, there is no fluke.
Yes,
there is no coincidence.
Yes,
everything is intentional.
Yes,
if you see a man enjoying God's blessing, it's either he has paid the price or somebody paid it for him. There is no fluke or coincidentality as long as you are a child of God. So the womb that gives birth to the things that you want to see in the physical is called prayer. So when you go to the place of prayer, listen to me guys, turn your house, your car, anywhere to prayer. You become an altar. I mean, a time may come, listen to me guys, there is a grace, there are different kinds of grace. There is a grace that you need to beg people to get money. There is a grace that makes some certain kind of people to come to you.
Come on.
There's a grace you carry. It makes educated people to come to you.
Come on.
There's a grace you carry. It makes poor people to come to you.
Oh.
But there's a grace you carry. It makes all men.
Ah.
There are dimensions that you encounter in the place of prayer. No one says to talk about Jesus Christ. After he has prayed, he's done to come and say, all men seek you. Poor, rich, educated, illiterate, they all came. I began to say, that those things happen in prayer.
Oh, yes.
Don't tie your life to that job. There is more in God.
Yeah.
There is more in God.
Yeah.
That's this month on Friday. Find your way. If you need to trek here, trek here on Friday. Let us encounter some things in the spirit that will turn your misery into breakthroughs.
Yeah.
Who says a big amen to that?
Yeah.
What are the tools the enemy uses to discourage prayers? I'll share this, then we close. The tools that the enemy uses to deflate the cloud of prayer. The tool, the devil is smart. He has aids to his advantage. He knows who you are. He knows your weak points. He knows what you like. That's why sometimes when you are praying, say, today I'm going to pray, today I will pray, today I'm going to pray, today I will pray. As you open your mouth and say, Kele, what shall I? They just show a movie on Netflix. Say, Father, excuse me. I've been looking for this movie since. Father, have mercy. He knows your weaknesses. That's why when you make a man to pray, say, today I will pray 3 hours. Some strange demonic sleep. We just blow. And the weather will not cooperate with the breeze. Before it was happening, you begin to say, Father, I bind you, Lord. I bind you. That's all. It is just a little money in the account. Maybe they have been fasting and praying. They will say this one, now hold the oil. Now hunger. Demon, this is because God is the priest of the earth. He knows how to color, he knows how to manipulate.
Yeah.
Anybody who tells you devil does not prosper, the person is an ignorant person. But there's a difference.
Yes, sir.
It is only the blessings of the Lord that make it rich and adds the sorrow.
That's right, that's right.
But there still it is. True, durable riches is still available in the body of Christ.
Yeah.
Hear me, guys. He knows some people, it is, they'll just say that, please. If you're a lawyer here, the pastor, you know what I'm talking about. That's what they call settlement after court, outside court. Abi, they settle the say, devil say, devil, demon, holding Angelina, come, please, go and release that 200,000 into our account. So you see the sister will be praying, Kelebo, Kelebo, and say your last, Kelebo, Lele, Lelebo, Lele, 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 Malaka. Then you see the sister that is on fire. He stops coming to church. Because 200K are settled to the outside courts. Not knowing that she's supposed to be the one giving that 2 million out to people as charity. May the devil not deceive out of a destiny.
Yeah.
Moses stood before Pharaoh. Pharaoh said, let all the men go. Leave the men behind. Okay, let the men go. Leave your animals behind. Say, Pharaoh said, well, yeah. We shall go, all of us. There shall not be an hoof remaining.
Yes.
The devil knows how to settle people. If you look at your tenacity, say, the way this guy is going, he will break ancestral pattern. Settle him. Settle him, just give like 5 million. Then you see the brother just collect 5 million. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, thank you, my Lord. Then for 1 year, he doesn't pray. 1 year, he doesn't pray. Then by the time he exhausts that 5 million, the ancestral stronghold that was already cracking before would have been reinforced. Do you hear what I'm saying this morning? That's why when you stay in the path of prayer, stay there. It is better to sleep in the place of prayer than not to pray at all. So there's a tool the devil uses, and it's very common, that can bring even a giant down. A prayer giant. You can imagine the old Elijah. Elijah brought down fire, brought a revival. Yet a small word from Jezebel sent him packing and began to wish for suicide. There are tools, demonic tools, the enemy uses, but the one that is on the top is what they call condemnation. Shout it, say condemnation.
Condemnation.
The way you are talking is for say condemnation.
Condemnation.
If you know you're not condemned, shout condemnation.
Condemnation.
When you see Christians in church, when issue is on, they can't dance. It's condemnation. You see people in church, everybody stand up, you sit down. It's condemnation.
Yes.
They are in church, you see them. They look nice, but there's condemnation in their spirit.
Yes.
The spirit of condemnation has attached itself to them because they sinned yesterday. Because they committed yesterday. Then when it's time to pray, some people say, you know, when they start praying, Father, thank you today. Every power of my father's altar, ballistic missile, destroy them. They'll say, who is praying? Who's praying? You that lied yesterday. Then see, sister, elbow, Father, have mercy on me. Father, have mercy. Baba, have mercy now. You are an ignorant person. Who are you to judge another man's servant, whether he stand dead or fall it? Let me, guys. Condemnation is at the root of every prayerlessness. When the devil comes and tells you, reminds you, you know you committed abortion 10 years ago. That's why you're not married. You can never be married. Then you see the sister, Holy Ghost filled, God fearing, who only made a mistake, begins to withdraw from the place of prayer. Listen to me, guys. There's something about the presence of God that you encounter in prayer. Sin cannot survive there. The devil knows this. That's why he will not allow you to come into that place. Because when you come in there, look at that woman caught in the act of adultery. The mistake those people made, they would have killed that woman on the act. The mistake they made, they brought her into God's presence.
Come on.
Listen to me, guys. The devil will keep you outside the court with your sin. But the moment you drag yourself, you drag, you enter his presence. The lion in you will roar.
Yes.
Don't let the devil kick you out of prayer or fellowship with God because you're a sinner. You did this yesterday. And so what? Is he did it against you? Did I did it against you, God? You must be able to talk back. Devil tells you are a sinner, you did this. Talk back, and so what? Did I do it against you? Then enter into fellowship in prayer. You will see that the grip of that condemnation will die.
Yes, sir. I hear you, sir.
What is condemnation? Condemnation is a statement or expression of very strong and definite criticism or disapproval. I said that one more time. Condemnation is a statement or expression of very strong and definite criticism or disapproval. That means the devil disapproves you and tells you that you are not worthy of God's presence. You are not worthy to be married. You are not worthy to prosper. You are not worthy to receive a blessing. You are not worthy to live that thing you are praying for. It tells you that. It criticizes you. It tells you, look at you. You didn't pray yesterday. Say you want a blessing. You lied yesterday. Did you forget what happened to the prodigal son? The prodigal son went and wasted. Let me show you something, please. Turn with me to Luke's gospel. Let me show you something in the Message translation, please. Let's thank God. Jessica is back. I will give God a big hand. Amen. Woo! Jessica, my special daughter, is back. The way you are clapping, can you clap for the Lord? Hear me, guys. There are people God sends into your life part time, part time.
Yes, sir.
They may not have 1 million, but they are ready to die with you.
Yes, sir.
Pray for them all. As a businessman, you need them. Because it's not every time you'll be able to visit them. There are times that things will be hard. You need faithful, loyal people around. And she's one of them. Can we celebrate her one more time? I love you so much, Jessica. I want you to know that. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
All right, let me show you something quickly. Take your Bibles. Are you there? Are you there? Come on, are you there now? Look at what happened. I want to read from the Message translation. The Message translation. Look at what the Bible says here. Give me Luke's Gospel, chapter 15, verse 24. Verse 20. The Message. Look at the Message translation. Man of God, you love this. You love the Man of God. Look at this. When I saw this last night, I was jubilating. Some of you are confessing your sins to God. God is saying, I can't remember it. I don't know what you are saying. Come and collect the blessing. I can't remember what you are saying. What are you saying? Father, forgive me. 20 years ago, I did this wrong. Father, listen to me, guys. Condemnation renews past faults. Condemnation, it renews past sins. Make it feel like today. Please, I deliver you from condemnation today.
Amen.
I said, you are delivered from condemnation today.
Amen.
Every spirit of condemnation, lift your hand up, lift your hand up. Every spirit of condemnation, as you are hearing this word of liberty, let those spirit disappear in the name of Jesus Christ. Look at this. I want to show you something, what the Father looks like. Now, Jesus was giving a parable. Now, what is a parable? Parable is making known spiritual mysteries with plain language. Look at it. Luke chapter 15, verse 20. He got right up and went to who? Somebody is getting up to his Father today.
Amen.
I see somebody is rising up today.
Amen.
Somebody is rising out of condemnation today. You are rising and you are going back to your Father. You are rising and you are going back to your Father. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. When he was still long way off, his Father saw him. See, guys, God never left you. Tap your neighbor and say, God didn't leave you.
Then
don't tap it on the hand, tap the cloth. Look, just stress. Say, neighbor. That neighbor is not here. Say, neighbor. He said, guess neighbor is looking like a coronavirus. Say, neighbor. Tap the person, look to your right, your left. Tap the right, your left. Say, neighbor. Say, neighbor. God has not left you. The Father saw him. His heart pounding. Oh my God. What a good God we have. What an awesome God we serve. Can you give the Lord a big hand this morning? Amen. Hallelujah. As I'm preaching this morning, healings are taking place already.
Amen.
The devil is packing his load and leaving already.
Amen.
The sexual condemnation is leaving you already.
Amen.
Shout that amen louder.
Amen.
When his Father still long away of, his Father saw him and his heart pounded. He ran out and embraced him and kissed him. Verse 21, look at verse 21. Verse 21. The son started his... Come on. He started what? What did he start? Like some of you, go to God as you are praying. Father, I came today. I remember when I was 18 years old. Now she's 40 years old. So I remember when I was 18 years old. You remember I did abortion. I went to prison. I did this. Remember? He went on with his... Some people even, they sit down, they write their confession down. Confession number one. On Monday, I caused somebody to go better for your father. On Tuesday, I slapped somebody. On Wednesday, I did this. On Thursday, look at what God is doing to you. He continued his speech. Some people's speech is the reason why their prayers are not answered. Too much speech, too much grammar. Just go straight to the point. Let us come boldly to the throne of grace. Not with speeches, many speeches. Father, thank you, Jesus. Jehovah Yahweh, Jehovah Eshakana. As he's saying that thing, his mind is condemning you. He said, if they are praying, not you. So he wants to use that name calling to drown the condemnation. It's a spirit. You cast it up and say, condemnation, I'm not your property. He continued with his speech. Too much story he keeps speaking. You are beating around the bush. Like a guy that wants to toast a sister that is higher than him. There's no sister higher than you, than a man. They're not like that. There's nothing this way. But devil, condemnation can make you feel like that. I can tell you, this sister, you don't have a car, she has a car. Brothers in the house. If you are poor, don't look for a poor sister.
Yes,
sisters in the house. If you are poor, let's not go there. Listen, guys. Listen. We can compliment each other. Know what you are doing. Amen.
Amen.
Some people say, okay. So because God can prosper you.
Amen.
He went on with his speech. The speech can be some impediment to your life. Too much speech is not good for prayer altar. It's not good. Like, do you see anybody dating doctor? They go to the just speaking speech. No speech. They just call the Ifa. They start dancing to the Ifa. Dance to the Ifa. Ifa, say what you want to. Oh yeah. What's your name? Say my name is Ajagbadi. Ajagbadi. He wants to prosper. They give him the requirement. He brings it. He begins to prosper. No story going there. But some Christians, they can speak. Father Lord, I just want to thank you. Yeah, he knows you are the Yahweh, the El Shaddai. Sometimes some angels just say, "Oh, Jehovah, you need to try. You know, hear story." They can talk. Go straight, come boldly. Sometimes all these. They are all signs of condemnation. He continued with his condemnation speech. Father, I have sinned. Against God, I have sinned before you. I don't deserve to be called your son ever. I shall. That is the voice of condemnation. It makes you unworthy of God's presence. How can you be unworthy when he sent his only son to die for your sins? Are you okay? Who did this to you? Who did this to you? A God sent his only begotten son. The only treasure he has, he sacrificed it for you. And you say, nobody for his presence? You know, go better for that condemnation.
Amen.
Amen.
When you leave here today, chest out. Sit on this, guys. Money in your pocket, no money your or money in your pocket, no money in your pocket. It does not determine who you are.
Yes,
who you are is determined by whose you are.
Yes,
stop measuring your life because of the money in your account. For a man's life does not consist in the abundance of the things that he owns. I have seen. I don't deserve. When I saw this yesterday, I want to cry. Can you say you don't deserve God's? Are you okay? God didn't say, I don't want you to deserve it. Yeah, I tell you, I qualify you to deserve
Come
it.
On.
Amen.
Come on.
I qualify you by sending my son to die on the cross for you. So anybody tells you, because you're wearing trousers, you can't go to church. Tell the person, you did that for me.
Come on.
No. You didn't send the son. God sent his son to die for
Come
me.
On.
You are not my mediator.
Oh, yes. Yes.
I have sinned against thee, and I don't deserve to be called your son ever again. Please go to the next verse, please. Next verse. But the father was not listening to what it is he was saying. He's not listening. He was not listening to what they were saying. Oh, the story is not interested. The father was not listening. Talk about neighbor, say the father is not listening to what you, all your sins. Say he's not listening to all your wrongs. Now hear me. Is this a license to sin? God forbid. But I'm only telling you that the weapon that the devil uses against even the strongest prayer warrior is condemnation. The father wasn't listening to what he was saying. What was the father doing? Read one to read. He was calling to the servant. Holy, quick, quick, bring me a clean set of clothes and dress him. Stop there. He said, bring a new set of clothes and dress him. You know why I said to dress him? Because the father knows that the son will be so condemned, he won't be able to put on the clothes. So he had to instruct the servant. He said, put this cloth on him because I can see that condemnation has deprived him, even the ability of accepting good things. Some Christians, you tell them, God will bless you. Say, bless me. Sir, I just need 101. I'm okay. You don't know what's 101?
Yes.
Who knows 101? Let's see. Who knows 101? There's some say, I just need 100. I'm fine. God forbid. The operation process was set in motion.
Yes, sir.
You have been out of the family. Prayerlessness kicks you out of the family of God. Oh. Family ring, it means authority. Restore. Listen, the devil knows all these things. He knows. He knows. He knows this thing I'm telling you. He will not want you to practice it. He tells you. Well, he's a good preacher, thank God. But it's not with people like you. You know, in your family, nobody prospers. In your family, nobody does that. You know, he will try to paint. You see, you will try to paint it in your mind. But square up your shoulder, put your head up high. The one who died for you is still alive. The Bible says he's seated at the right hand of Jehovah and is making intercession for you. You will build that house. You will enter that breakthrough. Your children will prosper. You will ride that car. You will ride that house. You will have that money. You will have that contract. Everything they stole from you, I decree restoration. The father was not listening. Rather, the father began to shout on all the servants. Servants, are you guys stupid? Who are the servants? Angels. Angels, what are you watching my son like this? Restore him. Give him back his job. Give him back his blessing.
Yes, sir.
Give him back his crown.
Yes, sir.
Give him back his confidence.
Yes, sir.
Give him back his breakthrough.
Amen.
Give him back his money.
Yes, sir.
Give him back his authority.
Yes.
Condemnation is a disease,
yes, sir,
that is worse than HIV. Because condemnation does not only stand against you and God, it also stands against you and your helpers. That time somebody wants to help you, in your mind, condemnation, you say, what is wrong with him? No, is it because he has money? Who is he? Meanwhile, this is your helper, that's in you. But because condemnation has so dealt with you, you can't see yourself in his or her capacity. Then you begin to beat yourself down. Say, go to hell. Are you my God? Are you my God? If God sends you away, no one will come. There are two realms. There are realms of men. There are realms of God.
Right.
If God approves a blessing, if a man refuses, you are your own. Oh, you don't know?
Yes.
Oh, you don't know? God does not force anybody. God said to Ananias, he said, go to a city called Street. Go and bless a man called Paul for a prayer. That's what Ananias started. Father, you're not serious. I believe Ananias was saying, Father, you're not serious. That man is a killer. He killed your people. Are you a wicked God? Imagine if he was not a true Christian. That's how Paul would have remained blinded. But in the place of prayer, consistent prayer, even the unwilling mind will become willing. For the heart of the king is in the hands of the Lord. Like a water course, he turns it whichever way you will. Rise to your feet. Rise to your feet. If you want to clap, clap. If you want to clap, clap. Lift up your hands and say, Lord, deliver me from condemnation. Deliver me from condemnation. Say it. You need to pray that prayer from your heart. Pray it. I can't hear your voice, guys. For he that knew no sin became sin. Just worship and pray. Pray, Lord. See you highly lifted up, shining in the light of your glory. Romans 8:1.
Pour out your power and love, sweet, sweet, holy, holy, holy.
See you highly lifted up,
shining in the light of your glory.
There is therefore no condemnation to them which are in Christ Jesus, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. A man that prays doesn't walk after the flesh. He walks after the Spirit. This morning, all over this hall, those of you watching us online, those of you in this hall, those of you outside in the gallery, every spirit of condemnation leaves you now.
Amen.
The spirit of condemnation is the door to affliction. Because when affliction comes on you, it justifies the affliction. Poverty is justified by condemnation. Rise and fall is justified by condemnation. That's why you must reject it. Every time you want to pray or ask God for something, the devil tells you you don't deserve it. Shout at the devil, I deserve it and more.
Yeah.
There is therefore no condemnation. No condemnation. Lift up your hands and worship. No more condemnation in your life as we close this morning.
Pour out your power and love as we sing holy, holy.
Open the eyes, Lord. That is your own, condemnation will not let you get it.
Amen.
Now, believe what I said. Condemnation cannot, will not, it is a spirit. It blinds you from what is your own. It renews the fire of sin and iniquity. Please lift your hands up as you close. As those hands are lifted, I pray for you.
Amen.
Let condemnation leave you now.
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 Amen.
See you highly lifted up.
And his offerings, praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. With that in mind, God is not in need of our money, praise the Lord. With that in mind, let us give God this money with an offering, with the mindset that let's give to God what is befitting to him, praise the Lord. It is not a time to begin to give God our 400 naira, 200 naira. Women, praise the Lord. This is all God's meeting time. That money you resign for meeting, bring it down, hallelujah, and give us so that God can be pleased with your offering, hallelujah. With that in mind, let's lift up our offerings up. As we lift it up before God, let's send it on errand. Let's ask God to bless our hands that are lifted up. Let's thank him that out of the abundance that he has given us, we have come to say thank you, Jesus. Even if you don't have anything to give to God, lift up your hands and still just give him praise for the gift of life. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name we have prayed.
Amen.
Let's cast our offering rejoicing in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
You are